For me, Ian is the epitome of an Ontario folk musician. Having started by learning as much as he could about older traditions, taking up guitar, accordion, mandolin, concertina, bagpipes, fiddle, anything that connected, he went on to write brilliant and often very funny songs about weird past events. Who even knew about these things? And now he's created the Ontario Traditional Music Library, an invaluable resource. To me, the award is long overdue.
He's a multi-instrumentalist. He's played in so many different groups and still does. He's probably the most knowledgeable human I know about Ontario music, blended with Ontario history. He's a fantastic songwriter, a multi-instrumentalist. On top of all that, he's a visual artist, a painter, a printmaker. He's designed so many album covers. He is just integral to the scene in this province. He is an astonishing human being and musician and artist.
Hello, my name is Ian Tamblyn, and I'm delighted to be able to represent Rodney and his nomination for the Estelle Klein Award. Rodney has been a musician, songwriter, and community organizer in Thunder Bay for over 40 years, I think, and he has just been a fabulous voice for Northwestern Ontario. Before I run out of time, I just want to say one of the most important things is that Rodney has been all over Northwestern Ontario, teaching and playing in schools, First Nation reserves going up to Attawapiskat, Ear Falls, all over the place. He's also been doing benefits in Thunder Bay and has been a huge contributor to the Thunder Bay scene, as well as bringing history alive through several of his albums. I really support this man. I think he's a fabulous songwriter, beautiful singer, and great musician, and supporter of his community.
Hi, my name is Mercedes Cachat. I am co-artistic director for Sunfest, London Committee for Cross-Cultural Arts. I've been very lucky and privileged to work alongside Alfredo for many years. I would say that his biggest contribution to the Ontario folk community is precisely giving it an international perspective, bringing artists from all over the world to the Ontario folk community, but not only that, making it accessible to artists, audiences, and especially families for many, many years and many years to come. So congratulations, Alfredo, on this nomination, and thank you so much to the folk community.
Alfredo has gifted us one of the most wonderful festivals in all of Canada. For more than three decades, this person has relentlessly been on this mission to celebrate diversity through music and to celebrate folk music, not just of one type of people, but for everyone who makes up the cultural fabric of Canada. What you do is remarkable, Alfredo. Thank you to you and to your team for bringing us Sunfest.
Brian Gladstone is an incredible person. He has been a support to the artist community for years. I met him 20 years ago when he formed the Association of Artists for a Better World and started putting on the Winter Folk Festival that he has put on through thick and thin and bringing so much pleasure to the community at large through putting on this wonderful event and other events, his open stage at the Free Times Cafe. I mean, I can't mention enough things that Brian has done. He's got integrity, he's got passion, and that's just the tip of the iceberg.
Hey, Julian Taylor here, and I just wanted to send a big shout out to my good friend, Brian Gladstone. He is nominated for the Estelle Klein Award at FMO. I'm on my way there, I'm just at a rehearsal, and I can't wait to see everybody. Brian, you've done so much for the music community in Toronto and Canada at large. Winterfolk is just one example. You're a wonderful man, a beautiful man, and I'm so happy for you. Congratulations and good luck to all the nominees.
I first met Graham Lindsey as a fellow musician. We were in a band together backing up the fiddler, Sarah Burnell. I later learned that in addition to being a great musician, Graham was a technical wizard. He is very visible in our community through his web design work, but it was during the pandemic that he was the technical wizard behind, I think, most of the folk streaming events that replaced live appearances during those 2 years. This and his great work with the CFMA Board of Directors make him a most deserving nominee for the Estelle Klein Award. Congratulations, Graham.
Over the years, we've seen Graham become the ultimate folk artist, but first and foremost, he has been the ultimate folk lover and supporter. You may have gotten to know Graham through one of his many talents. He could have worked on your website or streamed your live show during the pandemic. He could have been at that trad session last week playing his mandolin or his flute, or you could have dealt with him for the Canadian Folk Music Awards, where he's been a long-standing member on the board there.
Well, I think the thing that strikes me about Lillian, I've known her for many, many years, and through many different events and happenings in the folk community here in Ontario. And the thing that strikes me about Lillian is her enthusiasm and her excitement about the music. And I think that's why Acoustic Harvest Folk Club has been so successful. She just brings so much joy and energy, and just wants to spread the word about the music that she loves. And she has been incredibly supportive of many musicians in the folk scene in Ontario, and through Acoustic Harvest Folk Club and other things that she's done, she's just tried to help spread the word about people's music and get more people excited about folk music in the Toronto area and beyond. So I think it's really great that she's being recognized by the Estelle Klein Award Committee.
Greetings to Folk Music Ontario Awards, and a hearty mazal tov. Congratulations to Lorie Wolf for this Estelle Klein Award nomination. It is such a well-deserved award. I know how difficult it can be during the pandemic times in particular to keep community music programs and communities together and thriving, like the Toronto Klezmer Society. And the fact that it's going strong is largely due to your efforts. So congratulations, mazal tov, on this well-deserved honor and award, the Estelle Klein Award nomination. Mazel tov.
Lorie Wolf has done a really great job of building community around klezmer music in Toronto, and educating a lot of people and providing an outlet for those of us who love to play klezmer music in Toronto. So I think she's very deserving of the recognition.
David and I have played hundreds of concerts, countless festivals on three different continents. He's a great travel companion, but what I love most about his playing is he gets fancy, he plays a lot of lead, brings these incredible sounds and atmospheres to the tunes, but in all that, he never loses the beat. And if it's anything you want in a bass player, it's somebody who doesn't lose the beat. I love playing with David Woodhead, I love working with David Woodhead, and I wish him 100 more years.
Thank you, David, for your many long-standing contributions to the Canadian folk music scene.
David, since I first heard your unmistakable bass playing with Don Ross, I've been continuously inspired by everything you bring to the music community.
Your interest and involvement in world music traditions has expanded and made our community more inclusive.
Your enthusiasm and willingness to collaborate with younger artists embodies so much of the spirit of what we do.
And your outstanding musicianship keeps all of us players on our toes and makes every artist you play with sound better.
Congratulations!